grownfolksmusic.com.
The song that I chose was I Was Made to Love Her.
Oh, wow.
Which is 1967. It's a Motown subsidiary, Tamla Records, something like that. But this entire album, which is titled I Was Made to Love Her, has a lot of writers on there with soul tags. It's James Brown, Ray Charles is on there. There's all types of folks. But this song right here speaks to me, and it speaks soul to me, and it's my first choice, Stevie Wonder.
Oh, wow.
I Was Made to Love Her.
So let's take a listen to it. Yeah, we're just going to be playing clips here because, as we explained on another podcast, we want to be in compliance and, you know, respect copyright law. But here's a little clip. Let's see what we got here. Not that clip, this one. Just keep going. Oh my gracious, what a great way to start us off.
I figured you'd like that one.
I mean, there's so much in that. I mean, and the trip part about it is just looking at it, it's only 2 minutes and 36 seconds. But that's like the best 2 minutes. That's like the best 2 minutes and 36 seconds. And I mean, just my response. One, like you said, I mean, all the folks that worked on this. This is the height, I would say, of the. Motown has so many. You know, it's like. More than just old and New Testament Motown. I mean, this is certainly like, I guess, chapter two or three, maybe. This feels like this. It still sounds like Detroit. You know what I mean? If you know what I mean, like this. I mean, it's definitely the Funk Brothers playing because that's James Jamerson without a doubt on that bass. You know, and then just the doubles, right? So you got that figure, doo, 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 and then the double on the guitar with the sitar effect. So they were like being influenced by like, I guess, Sgt. Pepper's or whatever. You know, it was like all that stuff floating around. Oh my gosh, what a great way to start us. And what about? I mean, this is definitely soul. I mean, like what is it for you? What is it about this that squarely puts it in the soul category for you?
So I had a time kind of differentiating what I thought was soul. Okay. And, you know, the 60s was full of a lot. And soul and funk were kind of going hand in hand. I'm a big funk guy. So I tried to pick songs that were a little less funky, but still had soul. And a lot of that had to do with what they were speaking about, a lot of love, you know, and then just the way the juxtaposition or how they were riding the beat, you know, I guess how what it makes me feel like inside, it makes me glow a little bit. Funk kind of stinks up your face a little bit, you know.
That's true. Oh, what a great way to, great way to put it. Yeah. Cause, to me, that definitely, it's, like you said, it has a lot to do with like lyrical content as well as what's happening musically. And whenever I hear like that era Stevie again, it just, it puts me in the mind of that's Detroit. We talk about Stevie all the time and we could, you know, but I mean, obviously when we're talking about the great run, it's Motown in quotes, is Stevie. But it all that stuff was recorded in New York, basically. So it doesn't have that. It's just something about that era and those records up to like what through My Sharia Moore.
Okay. Yeah.
Maybe coming where I'm. Maybe that's the last one that sounds sort of Detroit-ish to me. Yeah. But yeah, this one. What is he? 16, 17 years old.
Yeah, he's still a baby, a boy. He's making hits. Yeah. You know. Yeah.
It's ridiculous.
It's impressive.
GrownFolksMusic.com.